Welcome. I am Colonel Jason Patla, the Commander and Senior Military Instructor of Detachment 157. I'm a 26-year weather officer for the Air Force, now entering my third and final year at Embry-Riddle. You will hear a brief introduction from each of my staff shortly, but rest assured, all are here to make this fall semester run as smoothly as possible for you. For our new students, a very special welcome. Though the health-related circumstances you arrive under are unfortunate to say the least, the challenges are not insurmountable. You have joined a phenomenal detachment of young men and women led by Cadet Colonel Caitlin Pesolano, who have shown willingness to raise their hands to put their service before themselves and support their nation in a powerful capacity as a U.S. Air Force or Space Force officer. Though freshman year in ROTC is typically a kick-the-tire period of your college experience, where you can determine if the military is right for you, you will likely not get the full or traditional experience, at least this fall. I recommend you communicate with your experienced cadets both virtually and in person, when conditions allow. Lean forward on your own to understand what this is all about. Take it upon yourself to not do the bare minimum, but rather exceed in everything you can. When in doubt, reach out to your instructor or another experienced cadet. I promise we will do our best to support you. With that said, academics must come first, followed by fitness and in everything else. Military life is not easy, but it is rewarding in so many ways. We typically start freshman class with well over 200 students, but by the end, we're only commissioning about 30 second lieutenants 4 years later. Clearly, this is a program that is both competitive and not for everybody. But if you want it and you do what's required, stay healthy, get good grades, stay strong, follow the rules, and push yourself, 4 years from now, you could be a commissioned Air Force or Space Force officer, which is exciting to say the least. Returning cadets, an enthusiastic welcome back. Our cadre and I sincerely hope you had the most enjoyable summer possible. As for the reality of our collective situation with this COVID-19, this virus, think of it as the enemy. We really must do everything within our power to prevent it from harming ourselves or those around us, physically, mentally, or spiritually. We must collectively work hard to ensure you receive the best academic education and preliminary military training possible. Obviously, things have changed a lot in the last 6 months, and I imagine they will continue to change. We must remain flexible yet also accountable. And with that said, we've dubbed this as the semester of personal accountability. A lot of it's going to fall back on you, and we need you to step up now more than ever. As returning cadets, you know exactly what's expected of you, so it should make no difference if you are with a cadre and a large group of cadets or on your own, studying, learning, and physically training for the mandatory Air Force fitness assessment when the time comes. What you will not have is the extensive in-person oversight from the past, but I'm confident you will take this challenge upon yourselves, step up as the amazing young men and women you are, and thrive under these restrictions imposed by the reality of a pandemic afflicting our university, our state, and our entire nation. Just for reference, the most significant changes will include greatly reduced face-to-face time in the classroom, as well as with your instructors for counseling. You can expect roughly half the number of PT sessions as a group as well, as Cadet Wing Leadership looks to train half of you on Monday and the other half on Friday instead of everybody both days. The rest is up to you as individuals to meet these requirements, but extensive physical fitness guidance will be provided by your cadet wing leadership to help you along the way. For our leadership laboratories on Wednesday, we will mostly be outdoors and remain on the ROTC side of campus. In small groups, you may be safely assigned training indoors as needed. Here again, you can expect a significant increase of virtual training in very few, if any, formations or events with the entire cadet wing this semester. Please remain flexible and informed. With all that said, I ask you to embrace the challenge of Embry-Riddle's president, Dr. Butler, and remain influencers across campus and around the local area, no matter if you are in uniform or civilian clothing. It is not just enough to say we will do the right things. As an organization, such as our detachment, we must be seen doing the right things, everywhere and all the time. People, both fellow students and your respective faculties, already look up to you for discipline and leadership. Show them your integrity and what you're made of by following the university health and safety guidelines. All of our associated universities share this request. Embry-Riddle, Bethune-Cookman, Stetson, and Daytona State. If our personal request isn't enough, please understand the following guidelines that following these guidelines has now become part of your respective honor codes, and failure to do so may have consequences by your university that are beyond our detachment's control. I will close by asking you three simple things. First, shine. Shine by doing what's right when nobody's looking. We also call that integrity. Second, exemplify service to each other and to those around you while remaining personally accountable for your actions. And third, do your absolute best to show excellence in all you do. Though 2020 has been and will likely continue to be difficult for all of us, I have confidence that we will all succeed in our efforts. The Cadre and I wish you the absolute best of luck and of good health as you move through this fall semester. Thank you very much for your time, and God bless.
I am Captain Derek Rose, the Operations Flight Commander and AS-300 instructor for Detachment 157. This is my fourth and final year with the detachment. It's my job as the OFC to work with your Cadet Wing Commander and her staff to plan and approve all of the training that you are going to go through this semester. As the Colonel already said, this is going to be very different than in years past, so we're going to rely a lot on your personal motivation and dedication to make it through this program successfully. I've been in the Air Force for over 13 years. I started as an enlisted space operator and became an officer space operator. In September, I'll be the first and only cadre from Det 157 to switch over to the U.S. Space Force, the newest and best branch of the military. So if you have interest in space or questions about that career field, I'm happy to answer that or any other questions that you may have about anything else. Thanks and have a great semester.
Welcome, cadets. I am Major Robert Manifold, the incoming deputy commander for the detachment, as well as an AS-100 instructor. I am a 12-year acquisitions officer, and I am fresh back from an overseas deployment. I am truly excited to share my military adventure with you as I help many of you begin your own. I will be arriving in the detachment in late September, and I look forward to meeting each and every one of you as the time and the situation permits. So welcome, and let's get to work.
I'm Mr. Fletcher. I'm a AS-100 instructor, one of the primary instructors for a bunch of your first-year cadets. I'll have quite a few of you in class as we move forward through this year. I'm a retired Air Force colonel. I served 34 years active duty. I was an F-15 pilot, flew a lot of our trainers, and I started out even as an enlisted crew member, and I was a tail gunner on B-52s way back in the day when we used to do that. So I'm looking forward to this year. As we always do within the Air and Space Forces, we adapt, we change, we overcome, and we succeed. And that is the same thing we will do this year together. So we will figure this out. I'll see many of you in class, or we'll see you virtually as we move forward, but we will be successful. Have a great day.
Hello, my name is Major Daniel Spiker. I'm going to be one of your AS-200 instructors, as well as taking over recruitment flight duties here at Det 157. I've been here for approximately 2 months. I've spent 20 years in the U.S. Air Force, my first 10 in the enlisted corps, and then these last 10 I've spent as a 13th Sierra or a space operations officer. I want to say welcome, and I look forward to working with all of you.
Hello, I'm Captain Kvassager. I've been here at Detachment 157 for a little over a year. I've been in the Air Force as a developmental engineer for about 10 years, and I will be teaching the AS-200 level classes. Welcome to Detachment 157. I look forward to seeing you this year.
Hello, cadets. I'm Captain Brooks. I have been at the Det since May. I will be teaching your 100 level courses this fall. I have been in the Air Force for about 7.5 years as a 17 Delta Cyberspace Operations Officer. I look forward to working with you this semester and throughout your career to help you develop yourself into a leader in today's Air Force.
Hello, my name is Master Sergeant Kiera Luster. I've been in the Air Force for 16.5 years as a Personnelist or 3FO. My role here at the detachment is NCOIC of Personnel. I've been here for the past 3.5 years overseeing all of the personnel actions within the NCO office. I want to welcome you to the detachment and say that I look forward to working with you this semester.
Hello, my name is Tech Sergeant Kuros. I have been in the Air Force 8 years, and I have been here at the detachment almost 4. I am a 3F5, or administration. Here at the detachment, I am the NCOIC of the security and commissioning programs. I wish all of you the best of luck throughout your ROTC career and your educational career as well.
Hi, this is Staff Sergeant Kelsey Rupert. I've been at the detachment for about 3 years now. I've been in the military for almost 11. I'm the medical NCOIC, so any medical questions or DOMIRB exam questions you might have, you can definitely come to me and I will try to get them answered for you. I'm looking forward to meeting each and every one of you.
Hi, I'm Staff Sergeant Paige Welch. I have been at the detachment for a year and a half and in the Air Force for a total of 6.5 years. My career field is personnel, so I'm a personnelist. My role at the detachment, I am the pay NCO and the uniform room NCO. So what that means for you is if you have any stipend questions or textbook related questions, you can direct those to me. And if you have any questions about uniforms as well, PT gear, or you will have OCPs. So if you have any questions about those, you can shoot me an email. I just wanna say welcome to the detachment and I look forward to working with you.
Hello, I am Sergeant Snow. I am your scholarship and enlistment NCO. Welcome to Det 157.
Cadet Colonel Caitlin Pesolano, Cadet Wing Commander. I'm excited to begin this fall semester, along with my staff, the senior cadet leadership at Detachment 157. We've been working hard this summer to plan and coordinate how training will be carried out. First and foremost, safety is our top priority. We work to ensure that we minimize health risks while still training to the fullest extent. However, this is going to be a team effort. We'll be relying on everyone, POC and GMC, to follow the policies that have been put in place. We're seen as leaders across campus and need to act accordingly with utmost professionalism, even when it seems like no one's watching. As the Colonel will tell you himself, this semester is going to be a test of your own accountability, self-discipline, and integrity. You will be expected to put in the work and effort needed to succeed with less oversight than in the past. We don't expect perfection. We expect you to make numerous mistakes, but we expect you to learn and grow from these mistakes. Don't be complacent, but rather seek to improve a little bit each and every single day. Along with this, wingmanship will be more integral than ever. You'll not make it through this program alone. Each and every one of you should strive to pull each other up and reach out when you find yourself faltering. For the new AS100s, by joining our cadet corps, you're now part of the Det 157 family. We will do everything we can to help you succeed, and we expect you to do the same for your peers. The motto for this semester is per angusta ad augusta, or through difficulties to honors. We're presented with unique challenges in this time, of which you are all acutely aware. As future Air Force officers, we will not allow these obstacles to slow us down, but rather we will adapt and overcome in order to get the mission done. Do not be passive. Do not let the circumstances we find ourselves in just happen to you. Be an active force for good, both in this program, in your college career, and in your personal lives. Onward and upward.
Cadet Lieutenant Colonel Rotundo, Cadet Vice Wing Commander.
Cadet Lieutenant Colonel Kelly Ivey, Mission Support Group Commander.
Cadet Lieutenant Colonel Ryan Bowen, Operations Group Commander.
Cadet Lieutenant Colonel Dashler, Maintenance Group Commander.
Cadet Lieutenant Colonel Zinnen, Public Affairs Group Commander.
Cadet Lieutenant Colonel William Lacey, Inspector General.